Welcome to our lesson 4 in linear programming, and in this lesson we are going to look at linear programming, or what we call optimization. So linear programming is an optimization technique aimed at finding the values of variables that maximize or minimize the objective function. Optimize means the action of making the best of most effective use of a situation or a resource. So in lesson three, we considered inequalities with several possibilities. In this lesson, we'll deal with identification of possible solutions that will give us possible maximum or minimum. So this is whereby in lesson three, we dealt with the various options. But in optimization, we look at the option that will give you the maximum or the minimum. This means that, for example, if you are transporting students, a teacher is transporting student, he has to, and is given a certain budget, he has to decide either to use, and is using maybe minibus and the small van, the Nissan, then he has to decide how many minibus to use and how many small van to use, so that the budget can fit. The more the teacher is able to utilize the two types of vehicles, he will be able maybe to save a little from the money available and be able to transport maximum student. In business, if you are selling something, two types of maybe maize flour, you mix the two and you want to make the maximum profit, you must know the ratio and how, where you are going to make a maximum profit. So that is what you'll be dealing with in this section. It is one of the sections that confuses many students, and I hope today, after going through it, you'll be able to understand it. Here we are going to use the technique of a ruler and a set square to be able to determine the minimum and the maximum. So let's do an example and see how it works. In our example one, we are told a farmer needed to transport 1,000 bags of maize to the cereals board of Kenya using a lorry and a pickup. The lorry can carry a maximum of 80 bags, while the pickup can carry a maximum of 20 bags. The pickup is to make more than twice the number of trips the lorry makes, and the total number of trips has to be less than 30. The cost per trip is 2,000 Kenyan shillings for the lorry and 900 Kenyan shillings for the pickup. Find the minimum expenditure. So for us to do this, we need to form the inequalities necessary. So we can start with let the number of trips made by the lorry be x, and pickup be y. So we can say the number of trips, we are told the number of trips to be made are less than 30. So we can say x plus y is less than 30, the number of trips. Then again, we are told that the lorry carries 80 bags and the pickup carries a maximum of 20 bags. This means that if we multiply the number of bags carried by the lorry plus the number of bags carried by the pickup, should be less than or equals to, or that is, should be greater or equals to 1,000. If we simplify this by dividing by 20, divide by 20, divide by 20, we will get that 4xy plus y is greater or equals to 50. So that is what we get when you simplify. That is from you need to transport 1,000 bags. So the number of bags should not be less than 1,000, should be more or 1,000. The other inequalities are the pickup is to make twice the number of trips the lorry makes. So if we take Y, the number of trips made by the pickup should be greater than 2x, the number of trips made by the lorry, and therefore and then we have x is greater than zero. So with these inequalities, we need to find the minimum. By minimum, we mean the minimum expenditure the farmer will incur by using the pickup and the lorry. So our aim here is to get how many trips should the lorry make and how many trips the pickup makes to make the minimum cost of transport. We are told that the lorry charges 2,000 shillings, the pickup charges 900. So that is what we mean by optimization. This is the grid that I'm going to use, and I've already inserted our inequalities that we have come up with. So with this one, we can get the equation is x plus y is equals to 30. We get the points when x is y, x and y. So when x is, we can say when x is 10, we substitute y is 20. When x is 20, y is 10. Then with this one, we say that's 4x plus y is equals to 50. We make our table. In this case, I just want to use 2 points so that it doesn't take a lot of time. So we have our x and we have our y. When x is 0, y is 50. And when x is 10, y is 10. With this one, we say y is equals to 2x. We make a table. We say that is x and this is our y. So when x is 0, y is 0. When x is 20, this will be 20 times 2, y will be 40. And then this will be the graph of y is equals to x is equals to 0. So with this, then we can be able to plot the graphs. So I'll start by labeling my axis. So I can use that is 10 at 0, starting point, that is 10. This is 20. This is 30. And this is our x-axis. This other one we have, this is 10. This is 20. This is 30. This is 40. This is 50. And this is our y-axis. I have labeled like that because you can see the maximum value of y here is 50, and the maximum value of x we have is 20. So our graph will be able to cater for that. So with that, we go ahead and plot the graphs. Start with the x plus y less than 30. So when x is 10, y is 20. So that's our point there. When x is 20, y is 10. X like that. And because our symbol here is less than, we are going to draw a dotted line or incomplete line because that is not inclusive. So that is the line y is, this is the graph of x plus y is equals to 30. We need to make it dotted. It should be look like that. And then we have a we check the side that needs to be shaded off. So we check with 0, 0. So when x is 0 and y is 0, 0 is less than 30. That's correct. We take another point like 20, 20. So 20 plus 20 is 40. It is not less than 0, meaning that this is the side that we need to shade off. So that is the side that we don't need. The other line is 4x plus y. So we need to get this point. When x is 0, y is 50. When x is 10, y is 10. So that is the point. We join the two points to come up with a graph. So this is a graph of 4x plus y is equals to 50. Then we check the side that satisfies our inequality. Let's take 0, 0, 0, 0. So when x is 0, this is 4 times 0 is 0 plus y is 0, 0. 0 is not greater than 50. So that is the side that we don't need. So we shade off that region so that we are left with the other part. So we have shaded off that. The other one is, it is a complete line because 50 of our symbol here, it is greater than or equals to. So 50 is part of the inequality. The other one is y is equal to 2x. So when x is 0, y is 0, so we get that point. And when x is 20, y is 40. When x is 20, y is 40. We join the two points to come up with the graph. That's the graph of y is equals to, as a graph of y is equals to 2x. It is dotted because of our symbol here. It is greater than. So 2x is not part of the inequality. So we get this, we look for the side that satisfies our inequality. Let's take 10 and 0. So if we say x is 10 and y is 0, 0 is greater than 20, that's not correct. So just not to take a lot of time, that is the side that we need to shade off. That is the side that we don't need. So we have our small region here that is represented by this inequality. Now, after that, we are going to get the objective function. Then from there we plot the search line. This is the region that we have obtained, and our region is quite small. So what I'm going to do is to magnify the region so that we can be able to see the various options that we have. I have magnified my graph so that we are able to identify the points, and one of the points is this one. This is a point of that is 7 and 22, so that is one option. So he can take 7 lorries and 2 pickups. Then the other point, since this line is complete, we can get that is a point which is we can say this is 8, x is 8 and y is 18. So that's another option. The other one is this point here, which is this point, and that point is 8 and 19. 8 and 19. So this here it is 8 and here it is 19. So that's another option. The other one is this one, and that is at 8 20 8 20. This is 8, the x is 8 and y is 20. The other one is this other point here, 8 and 21. The other one is we have this is that is 9, the x is 9 and the other one is 19. So that's another point. The other one is we have this point 9 and the other one is 20. So those are the options the farmer could take to transport the 1,000 bags. From here, let us calculate and see which option will give us the minimum expenditure. So we have identified the various options. let's calculate and see the expenditure. So if we take the first option, we have 7, you multiply by 2000, that is for the lorry, then you plus, there will be 20 times 900, and that should give you, using your calculator, you get it is at 3800. So that will be the cost for that option. For the other option, we have 8 and 18. So we have 8 multiplied by 2000 into bracket, and plus 18 pickup, so 18 times 900, and that should give us, that is giving us 32,200. Then we pick this other option where we have eight times 2000, that is for the lorry, then you add 19 times 900, and that is giving you that 3100. Then you pick the other option where we have 8 and 20. So we have 8 multiplied by 2000 close the bracket plus that is we have 20 multiplied by 900. This is giving us 34,000. Then we move to the other option. This is when we have 8 multiplied by 2000 plus 21 times 900, and that is giving us 34,900. Then we have the other option, that is for 9. So we have here we have brackets, and here we have 9 multiplied by 2000. Then you add to 19 multiplied by 900, and this is giving us 35,100. Then finally we have this one where we have 9 times 2000, then you add to the other is 20 plus 20 multiplied by 900. This is for the pickup, and that is giving us 36,000. So this is these are the various options the farmer could take. From the calculation, you can see that the lowest value, the expenditure, is where we have 32,200. So that is the lowest that is the lowest amount he can use to transport. We have done this so that when we come to determine optimization using Arura and Set Square, we can confirm that what you obtain using the instrument is the same, so that when you are given another a question like this one, you only need to use Arura and Set Square to determine the maximum or the minimum. So now let's go ahead and use Arura and Set Square to see whether we'll be able to obtain this value. For us to use Arura and a compass, we need to do a few things. Now, we are told that the cost of transporting using a lorry is 2000. So you put 2000x, the pickup is 900y. So this is called objective function. That objective function, what we do is we choose a point XY near or close to the region of possibility. In this case, let's choose the point 5 and 10. So this is 5 and 10, that point there. So we choose 5 and 10. We substitute in our objective function. So it says it is 2000 multiply by 5 plus 900 times 10, that will give you 19,000. That is a this is 10,000 plus 9,000, you get 19,000. Using this figure and the objective function, then we form this is this equation: 2000x plus 900y is equals to 19,000. We can simplify this by dividing by 100, 100 and 100. So you end up with a function 20x plus 9y is equals to 190. With this, this is called the search line. It is called the search line. We are going to plot this line. So we what we do here is we get 2 points. So we get x and y. And we see that when x is 5, you substitute here, this will be 100. Take it to the other side, you'll be left with 90. 90 divided by 9 will be 10. We have y is 0, x is 9.5. So they are going to use this point to draw our search line. So when x is 5, y is 10, so we have that point. When x is when y is 0, x is 9.5, so that's a point. We use those 2 points to draw that graph. So that is our search line, and it is a dotted line. So what we are going to do is using the search line, we are going to place our ruler here and our set square, and we slide the set square. And the first edge, the first point that the edge of the set square lands on our region, that is the point where we get the minimum expenditure. So let's go ahead and do that. This is how you do your setup. So place the ruler. This is my ruler along the search line. So one of the edges of the ruler to be along the search line. Place your set square. This is my set square, and holding the ruler down tightly, slide the set square so that in our region, the first point that will be touched by this edge will be the point giving us the minimum expenditure. So let's try and do that. So you move the set square upwards as you hold down the ruler. So that it does not move. So you realize that the first point where the set square touches the region, the first point as we had seen is the point 8 and that is 8 and 18, which was giving us 32. Let me magnify it so that you can see it clear. You can see as we slide our set square upwards, the first point the edge of the set square touches is where we have this is 8. You can see here x is 8 and y is 18, so it is 8 and 18, which we had found earlier that it is the option that is giving us the lowest expenditure. That is when the farmer will take 8 lorries, will take 8 lorries and 18 pickups. So that is where you make the minimum expenditure. So that is how you go about it. That is how you use the set square to get the minimum and the maximum. For the maximum, it means that it will be the last point the edge of the set square will touch as it exits the region. So that brings us to the end of this lesson. We are going to add other examples as we move on, but at least I have tried to explain how you go about it. You can go through an example and see whether you will be able to get the minimum or the maximum. So I'll be doing another example as we move on.